Hello Libra and welcome to Soul Sundays. Libra, it's a quick three card spread, one for your mind, body and soul for your week ahead. So let's get started. Universe and angels, messages and guides, my higher self, I call upon you now to give me a clear and accurate reading for the sign of Libra. Please tell me what they need to hear, not what they want to hear for the week ahead. Can I please have three cards, one for mind, body and soul? All right, my loves, how are you doing? Not surprising you've drawn the card of anxiety straight up for your mental attitude for this week. There's a lot going on in the sky, so let me give you a quick update. First of all, Venus has moved into Capricorn, and that's important because Venus rules health, wealth, beauty, what we create in this world, and it's in the sign of Capricorn, whilst Jupiter moves into Capricorn for the first time in 12 years on the 2nd of December. So having both there is a big focus on our wealth and our health, on what we're trying to create and bring into the world, okay? Jupiter is the biggest planet in our solar system, and the meanings of the planet, what it stands for, the energy, it's all about that expansion, growth, abundance, wisdom, luck, those good fortune things, okay? It's been in the home sign of Sagittarius for the past 12 months. Essentially, that's where it's at its happiness, right? When any planet's in its home sign, going forward, not going in a retrograde motion. And the energy's been all about opening up our hearts and our minds, right? Opening up, allowing us to dream big. What is it that you want to create and do in this world, right? For some of you, if you've been working really hard and diligently on a new plan, on something that you want to create and build in this world, on anything behind the scenes, and you've been doing it relentlessly, then this is a very good time of good fortune for you, because you could very well see your dreams and ambitions come into the fore, okay? The movement into Capricorn, whilst we've been, you know, having this very dreamy energy and opening our minds and our hearts and you know, thinking big, the movement into Capricorn now is like, right, you've got the plan, now it's time to put wheels in motion. It's about acting on those dreams, acting, putting them out there. So whatever it is, whatever crazy plan you've got that you've been thinking about, Libra, I want you to now, it's the year of action, right? It's a year of expansion. You're going to be expanding in all different ways, particularly if you have a Capricorn rising or wherever Capricorn is for you in your chart. It affects all of us, even for those that don't have a Capricorn sun. Another point in this before I get into your reading for this week, those who are turning, having a birthday next year, where you're turning 24, 36, 48, 60, 12, or 84, multiples of 12, it could very well be your year of your Jupiter return, okay? What does that mean? That's a very auspicious time. It's about great luck, very good fortune, a fantastic year for achieving your goals. Those that watch my channel regularly, you will know that I am a Capricorn sun. I'm born on the 11th of January, and I'm turning one of those birthdays next year. So it is my Jupiter return, which is freaking exciting, because I can't wait to share with you the stuff that I'm planning on bringing out that's above and beyond this YouTube channel in my hand that I show you every week. But more on that later. Let's get back into what this means for you. You've drawn the card of anxiety. Nine of Angels. This is where your mindset's at this week, Libra. One of the challenges of your sign is because you like to keep the balance and you don't like to rock the boat, you want everyone to be happy. Often that means that you don't speak up for yourself. And sometimes that could be at a lack of just feeling let down or not having the right support. In this book, it's described, this is the Nine of Swords, right? It's called the Nine of Angels. But in this book, it's described as the guardian, and that's for a really important reason. And I'm going to read to you the description, right? It says, anxiety rises in proportion to your loss of self-love. Your higher self yearns to calm your worries and restore peace. Tune in and feel it. So it's speaking about the fact that being vulnerable is okay, but being full of fear and inner torment is not okay. That's not a happy life to live for anyone, right? And the meaning of the card says, it tells a tailing trouble, right? You can tell it looks very worrying. Insomnia or sleepless nights can get the better of anyone. Don't lie there thinking and getting annoyed with yourself. Instead, breathe deeply and ask to connect to your guardian angel. There is no need to do this alone. Reach out to a friend, accept the assistance that's on offer. Negative perception may taint a genuine offer of help. It is wise to seek the counsel of others. 9 is the number of completion. Put an end to your doubt and start to trust your inner wisdom. It's massive for you, Libra. You know, it's about putting the boundaries out there within yourself, within the construct of your own mind first, and then about really looking at the environment of who's around you. And speaking of that, your spiritual message for this week is that of discernment, okay? I want you to be very careful about not only what you consume when it comes to your physical body, the food that you're nourishing your body with, okay? And if you are finding that that's a struggle, a really beautiful affirmation that you can either write down in like a journal or a notepad beside your bed or something that you can say out loud is, I help me to choose helpful foods, healthy foods. I choose healthy foods. I choose foods that nourish my body. I choose foods that help me survive and keep me healthy. You know, really try and train your mind, again, back to this card, about choosing the right things for yourself, okay? It's not easy. It's not something that comes naturally to everyone. And if it's something that you struggle with, then that's something that might help you, okay? Saying positive affirmations about choosing healthy foods, healthy substances, being attracted and drawn to healthy foods and healthy substances. But discernment doesn't also mean just about what you're consuming when it comes to food, okay? And I'm talking about food primarily because your body message for this week is consult a nutritionist. Okay, if you haven't done so already, if you're not seeing a dietitian or a nutritionist, it might be worth going to see one and getting a prescription specifically for you, for your body type, for where you're at, okay? But I want you to also be discerning about what you consume when it comes to social media, what you're looking at, what you're reading, what videos you're watching like this one. If you're finding that it doesn't resonate with you, just switch it off, okay? If you're consuming content that goes against the grain of your values, ask yourself, why am I watching this? Unfollow, okay? I want you to be very discerning this week. Catch yourself with what you're listening to. If you listen to certain podcasts that are all about rah, rah, let's make money, let's do this, but it doesn't click with you, then it's not the message for you, okay? It's not at the same vibration. You're not at that level. That's not what you need to hear. Be very careful with what you watch on Netflix, on television. Try and choose what I like to call the wholesome stuff, right? The stuff that you'd watch with your grandma. Well, depending on who your grandma is. But, you know, the stuff that makes you feel light and fluffy and like you're in a warm little blanket, okay? Choose more of that kind of stuff this week because I think it will help you balance out whatever's going on with your mindset that's causing you to have anxiety, a little bit of depression maybe, sleepless nights, that kind of thing. All right, my loves, that was your reading for this week. I hope you found it helpful. It's going to be a bit of a challenging week this week for you, and I'm not surprised with Jupiter moving into an Earth sign like Capricorn, Venus moving into Capricorn, you've got Pluto in Capricorn. It's a lot of Capricornian energy, and Capricorn is ruled by Saturn, which doesn't generally vibe too well with your sign. You know, it's all about structure. It's all about putting things into play. So focus on what you can control this week. Like I said, those little bits and pieces, watch what you're intaking when it comes to your food. Okay. All right. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please hit the like button. It helps the channel more than you know. Also, I just wanted to make a note for those that are interested in personal readings. I am available again. I've freed up my schedule. I'm completely up to date. The details are in the description bar below about how you can book in. I'm also offering yearly 2020 readings. So if you're wanting to get a full in-depth tarot reading for your year coming up for 2020, wanting to know what's coming for you, I'm offering those. If not, I will be doing them free for the channel sign by sign as well. So keep an eye out for that. All right, my lovelies, I wish you a great week ahead. Take care and I'll be back with you Sunday.